I found a love for me. Well, darling, just dive right in. Follow my lead. Well, I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. Well, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. Cause we were just kids when we fell in love, not knowing what it was. I will not give you up this time, darling, just kiss me.
I'm gonna be the man who wakes up next to you. When I go out, yeah, I know I'm gonna be the man who goes along with you. If I get drunk, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who gets drunk next to you. And if I heaver, yeah, I know I'm gonna be the man who's heavering to you. But I would walk 500 miles and I I'm gonna be the man who's working hard for you. When the money comes in for the work I do, I'll pass almost every penny on to you. When I come home,
when I come home,
oh, I know I'm gonna be the man who comes back home to you. And if I broke, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who's growing over you. But I would walk 500 miles and I
happy rise and goodness. It's a place that's very special to many, many people, and you come and grace it with your presence today. Thank you as you come to celebrate with Nick and myself. I'm going to sing our first hymn, which is Love Divine. Husband and wife may know the grace of God. It is given that as man and woman grow together in love and trust, they shall be united with one another in heart, body, and mind, as Christ is united with his bride, the Church. The gift of marriage brings husband and wife together in the delight and tenderness of sexual union and joyful commitment to the end of their lives. It is given as the foundation of family life, in which children are born and nurtured, and in which each member of the family, in good times and in bad, may find strength, companionship and comfort, and grow to maturity in love. Marriage is a way of life made holy by God and blessed by the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ with those celebrating a wedding at Cana in Galilee. Marriage is a sign of unity and loyalty, which all should uphold and honour. It enriches society and strengthens community. No one should enter into it lightly or selfishly, but reverently and responsibly in the sight of Almighty God. Stephanie and Nicholas are now to enter this way of life. They will each give their consent to the other and make solemn vows. And in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. We pray with them that the Holy Spirit will guide and strengthen them, that they may fulfill God's purposes for the whole of their earthly life together. But first, I'm required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. Same question for you two. The vows you are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who is judge of all and knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. Nicholas, will you take Stephanie to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Stephanie, will you take Nicholas to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
Hello.
And question for everyone here. Will you, the families and friends of Nicholas and Stephanie, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come?
We will.
We will.
Would you please stand?
Yes.
woman to be married to this man.
I, Nicholas David, take you, Stephanie Jane.
To be my wife. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish.
Till
death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God, I make this vow. I, Stephanie Jane, take you, Nicholas David. To be my husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish. Till death us do part. According to God's holy law. In the presence of God, I make this vow. Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Nicholas and Stephanie symbols of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Stephanie, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage. With my body, I honor you. All that I am, I give to you. All that I have, I share with you. Within the love of God. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Nicholas, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage. With my body, I honor you. All that I am, I give to you. All that I have, I share with you. Within the love of God. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. In the presence of God, before this congregation, Stephanie and Nicholas have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of a ring. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. It's done.
Anyone can catch your eye, but it takes someone special to catch your heart. All you need is love, a little chocolate now and then doesn't hurt. In true love, the smallest distance is too great, and the greatest distance can be bridged. Love is an irresistible desire to be irresistibly desired. True love stories never have endings. Love puts the fun together, the sad in the heart, and the joy in the heart. To the world you grow one person, but to one person you are the world. When love is not madness, it is not love. Trip over love and you can get up, but fall in love and you fall forever. Love is like playing the piano. First you must learn to play by the rules, and then you must forget the rules and play from your heart. A life with love will have some thorns, but a life without love will have no roses. If love is great and there are no greater things, then what you feel for each other must be the greatest.
A reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 1 to 13. If I speak in the tongues of men or of angels, but do not have love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have faith that can move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and give over my body to hardship that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It does not dishonour others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails, but when there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be still, and where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part, but when completeness comes, what is in part disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child, I thought like a child, and I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put the ways of childhood behind me. For now we see only a reflection as in the mirror, then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of all of these is love. Thank you.
Fedora tongue.
Yes.
Just put up your hands if you haven't got a friggin' clue what I'm saying. Right, ladies and gentlemen, and ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this wedding of Stephanie and Nicholas. It's a marriage in Scotland and England. What a shock. By the way, I hope you all managed to find a parking space for your combine harvesters. Enough about the English. It's a thing about the Scottish that everybody thinks that we roam the hills chasing haggis. Now, is that a fact or is it fiction? I've taken a walk in the hills of Ben MacDooley. As I neared the brow of the hill, I spotted a haggis. Now, to catch a haggis, you've got to be very wary in the wind direction. Because if he catches your scent, he'll just take off like a bullet and you won't find it. So, I took my position and I crept up behind it and I jumped in. Gave it a right good bashing to knock it out. Bagged it up, took it home. And the elusive Ben MacDooley haggis was sitting in my fridge. As we were coming down to Englandshire, I decided to provide Nick with a special gift. He was a fat bunny. Nicholas, eat up. Right. Let's get the facts, near fiction. On a more serious note now, I've got to know Nick quite well over the last few years. He's a serious golfer. But now and then, Noah is known for the odd expression. And he has picked that up from our language. They'll be on the tee, whack the ball, and then there'll be a wee comment. Well, that was shite. So I'm thinking you weren't happy with that shot, Nick. Now, Nick is very involved with the financial sector. Playing around with other people's money and savings and giving the best investment advice. It goes something like this. Well, Mr. Bloggs, congratulations on winning the lottery. Now, I'm here to provide you with sound financial advice and where to invest all your winnings. Now, I can give you a portfolio of investment companies that you may be interested in. Company one. This performs very well, but is a high risk factor. You might make some profit. But on the other hand, you might lose all your savings. Company two. This is a small risk fund, and you'll gain a very small profit, but on the other hand, you might lose all your money. By the way, Mr. Bloggs, After you've considered these options, please sign the disclaimer so that you can't complain that all your money has gone down the Swanee River and it's not my fault. That is the financial advisor's get out of jail policy. Or go to the bookies. Put your money on a horse called Giddy Up. Racing at Newmarket at 3:30, the odds are 10-1. This fund might produce a possible profit, but on the other hand, you might lose all your savings. That is a financial lesson from investment from Nick. Now, another side of Nick is when he's doing your financial planning, he's usually got about 6 cans of beer at the table. So I ask you, would you trust a financial planner who sits and drinks beer at his computer every day? You like a beer, do you, Nick? There's a thing about Nick. He likes sport. And he's the only guy I know. Like an international game, England v Croatia or something like that. He'll stand up in front of the TV. God save us! He'll give you the 4 verses. Nobody's watching them. Get a life, buddy. On a serious note, we've known Nick for years now, and he really has become a good friend. So I'm delighted to officially welcome you into the family, even though it may be temporary. Right, enough about Nick. I did hear more about Nick, but my wife vetoed most of it. Then Steph. I struggled to insult her because she's a fruit of my loins. And I kind of like her. Then the first daughter arrived. Steph. Steph was a great kid. Always a smile on her face. She went to school at Robert Gordon's College. Always a studier and strive to be the top dog in the class. Apart from poetry. She would come home and present her poetry homework. So a lot of humming and hearing went on at this time. So I had a look at the homework. And I did the poems. I can't tell about that shit. And make it sound as if it's good. So she took the poems to the teacher. The teacher got the idea she was a natural poet. Absolutely fantastic. You're a born poet. That was another tick in the box. Steph was a natural at music. She could pick up any instrument and play it. Piano, violin. One day she decided to play the bagpipes. Bagpipes was a bit sore in the ears, you know. If she was practicing, everybody was sitting like that. She was also a champion Highland dancer and competed well for many years. Academically, she's made us proud with her drive and hard work to reach the top of the echelons of the medicine circle. By the way, if anybody needs a new knee or another bone, give me the cash.
Thank you.
totally unmarked bills, by the way. So, Steph stands on her own 2 feet, and she's roughed it and duffed it to get where she's gone. Then, well done, Steph. Then she met Nick. And then along came Doggy Bruce, a new member of the family. But Nick was still hanging about, you know. Bruce is a cracking dog. How's it? Is he in here?
He's gone.
Is he? Yeah. Steph and Nick are a good match. And I would like to wish them well for the future. I'd like to thank you all for coming here today and joining us for Steph and Nick's special day. I'd like you all to join me in a toast. So please raise your glasses to the new Mr. and Mrs. Glasspool!
Welcome to Orchardleigh. On behalf of my wife and I, we would like to thank you all for coming here today to share our special day with us. With the events of the last 2 years, we are just absolutely over the moon to be able to host you all in such fine surroundings and see everyone having such a wonderful time together, and we're really, really grateful. We have many...
I'm going.
Oh! That's a £10 fine.
It's alright, he's just agreed to buy drinks for everyone.
Okay, so we have so many friends here today, far and wide, and we're particularly grateful for all the people that have made the long trip down from Aberdeenshire, Yorkshire, and London. We understand that planning travel in these uncertain times must not have been the easiest thing in the world, so it's very much appreciated. Unfortunately, the difficulties of travel have proven a bit too much for our friends from Canada and New Zealand, but they've sent us some lovely messages, and we're glad that they're here in spirit. Also, Steph's grandmother, Helen, is unfortunately not well enough to be with us to celebrate today. But we're going to make sure that she sees all the photos and the video. So everyone, Helen, who's watching on the video, hi. Both Steph and I have several relatives that we would have loved to have still been around to celebrate with us today. Unfortunately, you're no longer with us. In particular, we said goodbye to our grandma, Kath, in May. Before she passed, Kath made me promise that I would take good care of her granddaughter, and that's a promise that I fully intend to keep. So, ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a toast to absent friends. So, I don't know if you guys have noticed, but instead of wedding favours, we've made a donation on each of your behalf to the British Heart Foundation. I hope you don't mind too much, but this charity does some amazing work for people with heart conditions. They've supported me in the past, and I'm sure they've supported some of your friends and family as well. So, I hope that's it. So, I'm sure you can appreciate that a day like today doesn't organise itself, even if it seemed to me at times that it did. Steph has definitely taken the lead role, and what a wonderful job. Yes. I think she's done. Yes. But we've had a lot of help along the way, so it would be amiss of me not to recognise this name, and I sincerely apologise if I've missed anyone out. So thank you all to the staff here at Orchardleigh, our magnificent piper Tony, our singer Sandy, and thank you also to our photography team of Michael and Tracy. The support of our florist Leslie has been invaluable. And the last couple of years must have been so difficult for these guys in this industry, so we're extremely grateful for your help, patience and guidance throughout the last few months. So, a special thanks to Matron of Honour and my shiny new sister-in-law, Victoria. You look fantastic today, Vic, and you've been an incredible support to me and Steph in the lead up to today, and of course over the last 7 years. And we're both very, very grateful for your patience when our stock answer to any problem has been, see what Vic thinks. And thanks also for organising an absolutely epic hen-do for Steph in New York, and I know everyone had a fantastic time. To Steph's bridesmaids, Jan and Lisa, you look absolutely fantastic. And you girls have been brilliant friends to Steph, and you've been a great help in one way or another in the weeks of build-up into today. So thank you very much. So ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding again to join me in a toast to our wonderful bridesmaids. Thank you also to Vic's husband, my new brother-in-law, Andy. He's been an absolute star today, and he's been shouted at by many directions, and he's not complained once. And he's always at hand to deliver a beer to me when he can see that I just need one. thank you, Andy.
Cheers.
Thank you also to my groomsmen, to Dave, Tommy George and Sam. Thanks for the great job you boys have done for us at the church today, looking after everyone and making sure everyone got all their stuff. It's great seeing you dressed up smart for something like other than your next court appearance. you can chill out, boys, now. Your duties are done, so you can crack on with the drinking. Like you nutters needing an invitation. Thank you to our wonderful flower girl, Erin. You're brilliant and you look absolutely beautiful. Great job. And thank you also to our very handsome page boy, Harry. Ladies and gentlemen, you might not know this about Harry, but he gives the best high five in the world. And then Mum Alice, you've been amazing today and helped Steph a lot in the preparation. And I know that Steph greatly appreciates it, so thank you very much. So that was the easy bit. Now I think I might get a little bit emotional. But I'll turn to Steph's mum. Gillian, you look absolutely fantastic today. And Joe, despite what you said about me, you look pretty good in your kilt, all dressed up as well.
Objection, the law.
You didn't get an objection, it's my turn now. Raising Steph to be such an incredible person. It's obvious that you encouraged and supported her so well. You have instilled Steph with a wonderful set of values, kindness, compassion, integrity, and a work ethic just beyond anyone I've ever met in my life. And you have a daughter in which you can be truly proud. I remember being absolutely terrified at the prospect of meeting Steph's parents. However, I needn't really have been worried. We had a bit of a language barrier to start with. But we quickly worked out furry boots loon and wordy too young and me more or less the same thing. Since then you've welcomed me into your family with open arms and I'm really grateful. I'm always greeted at Croon and Bay with a warm hug and either a buttery or a fancy piece. Is that And I'm definitely never allowed to leave the Buckingham Tannery. Since our first meeting at Sheppey's Cider Farm, we've enjoyed some great times together, and we absolutely love having you down to Salisbury, and we really love coming up to exploring Scotland with you guys. You've been a real support to me and Steph over the last few years, and Gillian's help in planning today has been absolutely amazing. And we're both extremely grateful for your generous contribution to our equipment and today's events. I can also confirm, ladies and gentlemen, that mine and Steph's success as a couple has absolutely nothing to do with Steph's mum and dad a decent 9 iron away from the first screen at UK top 5 rated crude and bake-off club. That's true, isn't it? So, to my parents, Mum, you look wonderful today, and Dad, it is remarkable what a new suit and a haircut can do. Thank you for everything over the last 37 years. I probably wasn't the easiest boy to raise, and there must have been times when you were tearing your hair out. I'm not sure it got much easier as I grew up either. I just presented you with a whole new load of problems. I'm grateful for you both raising me in such a loving home, where the number one priority was and always remains me and my brother, despite the challenges that life throws at us. I'm truly blessed to have such wonderful parents. Going out to lunch with Mum and going to football or having a pint with Dad is a real privilege for me, and definitely not charity work, as you would say. Thank you for your help in us setting up home together and looking after our naughty little Westie, Bruce, on occasion, who hopefully you all had a chance to meet earlier. And thank you for being so welcoming to Steph. I'm not sure Steph necessarily liked being flagged down in her car and dragged inside for a tea and biscuit straight after a night shift in A&E for your first meeting, but I know that she appreciated the sentiment. I think I can speak for the both of us in saying that you've both been a tremendous support to us over the last 7 years. So as a token of our thanks, we have a little something for Cynthia and Gillian. Saw you walking down the aisle towards me. It was the most magnificent feeling I've ever experienced. I consider myself to be the luckiest man alive to have married you today. So you might have been able to tell by all the people that were at the church, pacing up and down and looking around and checking my buttons about 15 times. I was really nervous. I was also really nervous that Christmas morning that I asked you to marry me. But that's just because I wanted things to be right and not make a fool of myself. I've never been more certain of anything in my entire life. Steph, the success that you've achieved in your career is in part down to your obvious intelligence, but more importantly, your persistence, drive, and your incredible work ethic. What amazes me is that you see absolutely no ceiling on what you can achieve, and you just break through with new and greater achievements each year. It's just fantastic, and I'm absolutely in awe of you at times now. But it's really your kindness and compassion and love for your family and friends that truly defines you. We first met on a summer evening in the Harbourside in Bristol. Steph was very easy to talk to, and within an hour, I felt that we'd known each other for a lot longer. On our first date, Steph managed to subtly imply that I was too tight to buy a dinner. And Steph made me think it was my idea to stride across the road and reappear with a large bag of cheesy chips. It worked though, and I thank my lucky stars each day that M&M kebabs and burgers are still in there. But not long after we met, I turned 30. And having only been with Steph for a couple of months, I expected a present. I mean, who wouldn't? But maybe a bottle of Old Spice or a box of chocolates or something. But instead, Steph surprised me with an amazing trip to Paris. And Steph's dad, to be fair to him, was probably right to tell Steph that she was absolutely bonkers. But to me, it was a massive indicator that Steph felt the same way about me as I did for her. Since then, we've had some great holidays, and I really love that we have shared interests in exploring landmarks and historical sites. We've been on quite a journey overall. We make a great partnership. We play to our strengths, and we make up for each other's weaknesses. I'm so excited for this next big adventure together as husband and wife. So, if you'd like to join me in a toast, to my wonderful bride, Stephanie. Best man, my brother Rob. When I decided to ask Steph to marry me, I was absolutely sure that you were the man for the job. You've been there through some tough times over the last 18 months for me, and indeed over the last 34 years, and I could not wish for a better brother or best man. The expression right-hand man apparently originates from medieval battles, where the man on your right would cover you with his shield while things got tough in battle. So right-hand man is definitely complete, perfect description for Rob. He's had one of the hardest best man tenures in history, having to organise a stag do despite the ever-changing border restrictions and lockdowns and crazy rules. But what a job he did, and I'm sure all the lads that went to Liverpool would agree. And despite my warnings and threats, I'm sure he's going to tell you all about it. He's got a long list of talents that make him suitable for the role. He's a great listener, he has a mind like an encyclopedia, and he isn't afraid to tell you straight when you need it. And before I hand over to him, I should just tell you that he has an extremely vivid imagination. So you should not believe a bloody word that comes out.
Bit of a spanner thrown in the works. I have my speech all written up, ready to go, and then Carl, the compere guy, whatever he is, gave me this mysterious envelope with instructions to read it out. So, shall I do that at the end, or shall I do it now?
Now!
He's been driving Steph crazy.
It's addressed to me.
I'm really excited.
We won the lottery.
That'll be fun.
Okay, so it's on your wedding day, wishing you a lifetime of happiness as your hopes and dreams come true. Lots of love, best wishes. Uncle Kenneth and Auntie Rona.
Thanks, Rob.
That's an answer.
Some X's come out of the woodwork.
This is my speech.
Have a drink.
can tell, I've never done one of these. So I thought I'd start safely by saying Stephanie looks absolutely stunning today. Actually gave me goosebumps when I saw you walking down the aisle. You look fantastic. What else have I got here? and I'm absolutely delighted to officially welcome you into our family. So as well as looking amazing, Steph is an incredibly dedicated and hard-working doctor, and is, as Nick said, constantly pushing herself and growing and developing and doing more and more training. And now, if I understand rightly, you're kind of passing your knowledge on to other people when you're kind of teaching Robert. So yeah, just an incredibly impressive woman. And also, yeah, a fiercely loyal, protective friend, and the sort of person that you absolutely want by your side when the chips are down. So I think Nick has chosen very well, and definitely some punching upwards. And it's a pleasure to have so many of Steph's colleagues and doctors and healthcare workers in our midst. Apparently there's been some virus going around. we're all massively indebted to all the sacrifices and hard work that you've been put in over the last 2 years. That's the nice stuff, actually.
Yeah.
But he did that, don't you think? And I was honoured when Nick asked me to be his best man. Over the years, he really has been like a brother to me. From our short-lived hip-hop duo, Styling Gel, to our epic WWE-style wrestling matches. What else we got? And as Nick got older, I think he was quite reluctant to give up his bachelor lifestyle. Cutting down on the beer drinking and the golf, I think it didn't really seem to appeal to him. as their relationship blossomed, Steph sort of managed to domesticate Nick.
Working on it.
I was going to mention about the bear pants, but maybe I'll save that. and also when Nick first met Steph, we were very reassured to learn that Steph is an orthopaedic surgeon, because Nick's clumsiness is legendary. he once broke his hand when drunkenly recreating how he once fell off his chair. he cycled into a canal because he wanted to see what it would be like to ride with his hands together on the hand. Having seen their relationship blossom, I've no doubt that they'll catch each other whenever they fall. And anyone that knows Nick will know that he'd much rather tell you about the 4-iron you hit in a weekday medal in 2005 than tell you how he feels. But during some pretty intense wedding planning, he did tell me that the thing he was most looking forward to wasn't the wedding, but it was their marriage. And that he couldn't wait to share his life with Steph. So with that said, I would like to propose a final toast to the bride and groom.
For Mr. and Mrs. Glassford.
Someone who walks away so easily. I'm here to stay and make the difference that I can make. Our differences, they do a lot to teach us how to use the tools and gifts we got here. We got a lot at stake. And in the end, you're still my friend. At least we did intend for us to work. We didn't break, we didn't burn. We had to learn how to bend without the world caving in. I had to learn what I got and what I'm not and who I am. I won't give up on us, even if the skies get rough. I'm giving you all my love. I'm still looking up, still looking up. Well, I won't give up.
No, I'm not.
God knows I'm tough.
I am
tough.
He knows.
We got a lot to learn. God knows we're worth it.
And we're worth it.
I won't give up on us, even if the skies get rough. I'm giving you all my love. I'm still looking up.